So I've recently reinstalled Windows on my laptop, and while I was setting it up, I counted about 10 different steps I did to boost my Windows security. Yet it doesn't matter whether you just got a new device or realized your old device is a bit of a security risk, grab your PC and your comfort animal, and let's go through the steps together. First of all, you need to make sure that your Windows security tools are working properly. Obviously, don't keep Windows Defender off for no reason, since it's the main layer of protection against malware. Among the Windows security tools, you'll also notice a firewall. Windows Defender has a pretty good one, made to monitor outgoing and incoming traffic for suspicious activity, so keep this one active as well. Now, admittedly, the question of is Windows Defender good enough for full protection is a whole other topic, but if you don't have a separate antivirus, which I'll cover later, it's your OB1. Wait, no, I mean your only hope. Okay, step two is really simple. Go to the settings and enable automatic updates. Outdated software is often an open invitation to get hacked, since it may contain unfixed vulnerabilities, updates constantly patch them, so yeah, keep them going. That said, not all Windows PC software needs to be updated. If you get a new PC or reinstall Windows 11, it's already filled with tons of apps. If I'm not going to use them, it's only going to take up space, and the outdated versions can become a security risk. Ow! So I usually start by clearing out my start menu and all of the useless gadgets that are in there. Then I can look through the applications. Just make sure to Google the app names if you don't know what they are, since some of them can be essential for your Windows laptop to work properly. Do not delete System 32, alright? It's an old joke, you should know better by now. Another thing I recommend doing is creating separate accounts, especially if you're sharing your Windows PC. I like to have separate accounts for work and personal stuff, just so if one of them gets infected with malware, you know, there's a chance it won't be able to get to the other one. Also, if you're sharing your PC with a less tech-savvy person, shall we say, I don't know, like your parents, then perhaps giving yourself admin rights can be a great way to prevent them from accidentally installing malicious programs. Just don't get blinded by the power. Speaking of accounts though, make sure to protect them with proper passwords. You're only gonna lose a few seconds when logging in, but this will greatly increase your Windows security. Just don't make the passwords too easy. The same thing applies to all other accounts. I know, setting up different passwords and two-factor authentication for each online account is a hassle. And then you're spending even more time visiting the I forgot my password button than the actual login field. So hear me out here, alright? Password managers. I might be biased, but genuinely, it's so convenient. Most secure passwords are a random jumble and mix of letters and symbols and uppercase, lowercase, and come on, who has the brain capacity to remember those? I know I don't. So yeah, grab a password manager. There's plenty of premium and even free versions that will increase your Windows security by protecting all the different online accounts. While you could live without a password manager, for OS security and protection, I highly recommend getting a third-party antivirus. The reason is very simple. Windows Defender cannot guarantee all-round protection. If you manage to catch any nasty virus, it can slip right through and easily compromise its defenses. Meanwhile, third-party tools receive more regular updates, plus some of them have a 100% malware protection guarantee with refund policies or boast 100% independent testing ratings. I wouldn't go as far as saying they'll protect you 100% of the time, since, well, no software is actually that foolproof, but a third-party antivirus will often do a better job than Windows Defender. So if you want recommendations, Bitdefender and Norton are very good ones to start with. All right, another step that I do is focused on specifically data privacy and security, and that's getting a VPN. A virtual private network, which is what VPN stands for, is good for quite a few things, from encrypting my data and changing my IP address to accessing geo-blocked content. It's also going to protect you while using public Wi-Fi, and some VPN for PC options come with extra features like ad blockers, for example. There are a ton of VPN for Windows options to choose from, but if you're just getting started with improving your Windows security, I recommend looking into ones that cover a few security tools at once. For example, Surfshark has an antivirus and a VPN bundle, while NordVPN has a malware blocking feature called Thread Protection. Both of these are renowned and safe options, and they often have great discount deals running. If you're interested, there's going to be a link in the description. Of course, if you're mindful while browsing, you can get by without a VPN for Windows. So step 8 is, well, be careful online. Phishing scams and malware-infected websites are running absolutely wild these days, so be careful with suspicious links and weird websites. Or at the very least, use a link checker. If you opted for a VPN for PC though, it's likely that your VPN can recognize untrusted or malicious sites, so you can browse without worrying too much. Now, step 9 is to not download software from unknown websites. Yeah, I know, alright, a little bit of a stretch for a whole step, but 10 steps is better than 9, right? We had to have 10 steps. But besides, it's still actually important, confirm your software sources, and don't pirate stuff, or you're just bound to end up catching malware infections. Finally, step 10 is to make sure you back up your data. You can use an external drive or get some cloud storage, but this is something I swear by. Not only is it gonna help you in the case of data loss, but it's also gonna keep you safe in case of ransom attack. So yeah, these are my 10 steps to improve Windows security, whether you have Windows 11 or 10. Let me know if you do more things when setting up your Windows laptop. Also, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. I don't just discuss security things here. It's Cool Tech Zone after all. So why don't I meet you in another video, and I'll see you there.